they either require the TEAS test or they require the HESI test. I'm just going to read you this first little paragraph of the letter intent thigh symptoms. By the end of this video, you know everything you need to get into WGU's online nursing program. What's going on, guys? Cordero here with a couple nurses, and today we're going to talk to you about how to get into WGU's all-online nursing program. So first off, congratulations for deciding or even considering on becoming a nurse and looking for nursing programs. I've been in WGU's online nursing program for about 18 months now, and I've enjoyed it myself, and I've learned a lot. It's been tough. But what I want to do with this video is address some of those people that have questions about how to get into the online program. And what are the key factors that they're looking at when they're wanting to accept you? Remember, before we get into it, if you find any value in this video, be sure to hit the like button for me, subscribe, and if you find value, comment a nurse's rock in the comment box. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, guys, so the first thing you need to know about WGU and their online nursing program is that they love self-starters. So first off, they love if you have a degree already, whether it's an ADN, I'm not ADN, but an associate's degree or a bachelor's degree. They also like to see somebody that's working. With that being said, since they love self-starters, the first thing you need to do is contact an enrollment counselor. The enrollment counselor is gonna be your point of contact for WGU's online nursing program. They're gonna help walk you through everything you need to do, make sure you get all your paperwork turned in, make sure you get all these other things I'm gonna talk about handled. So they're gonna answer all the questions for you. So that's number one, is contact the enrollment counselor. Okay, so you've contacted your enrollment counselor, now what? So you're gonna need 10 prerequisites to get into WGU's online nursing program. I'll go ahead and drop those down at the bottom, the 10 prerequisites that got me enrolled. Now they take up to 13 transferable classes. But out of those, there's three that you really need to focus on. So that's your AMP1, your AMP2, and your microbiology. So just like with any other nursing program, they're gonna wanna see that you did pretty good in those classes. Me, myself, I made B's across the board in those classes. And some of my other prerequisites, I made C's. I actually had a really bad GPA, to be honest, coming into WGU, but I did really good on my sciences, so I think that looked good. I also took statistics, which transferred. You don't need to have statistics to get into the program, but if you have it, it does transfer. Biochemistry and pharmacology are two other classes that can also be transferable. Okay, so you spoke with your enrollment counselor, you've taken all of your prerequisites, cool. You're getting closer and closer to getting into their online nursing program. The next thing that they're going to be looking for you is something called a student statement, or a letter of intent is pretty much what it is. And since my GPA wasn't that good and my science classes were okay, I think that my letter of intent with the other pieces I'm going to give you here is what really helped me get into the program. I'm just going to read you this first little paragraph of the letter intent that I sent them. With this letter intent, you really want to make sure that you're telling them why you want to be a nurse, why do you want to go to WGU, and why do you think that you're going to succeed. And they want it to be about 1 to 2 pages. I got all mine on one page. I'm just going to read you the first paragraph so you can kind of see how serious you should take something like this, right? So, dear WGU Nursing Department, I'm submitting this letter in hopes to be one of the selected few for the pre-licensure Bachelor's in Science of Nursing program. I believe my background, focus, and winner's attitude will secure my acceptance into the program. And that's just the top little part, and of course, throughout the rest of it, I really went into depth about why I will be a successful nurse, why I will succeed in their program. So make sure you ace this letter of intent. All right, so we finished up our letter of intent. We're getting closer and closer. The next thing we're gonna want from you is letters of recommendation. I think it's from 2 or 3 professional sources. I think this is another factor that helped me get into the program because the people that wrote these up for me were phenomenal. They'll send you a template that pretty much has about 3 or 4 categories, and then it ranks it from not at all, less likely, to like very likely, or all the time, you know, those kind of quizzes. And you give this to your boss or a manager or any kind of professional reference that you have. Now what I did, I asked my references to not only fill that out, but also, you know, write up a paragraph or two about me, why I'm a good person, quote unquote, or why I will be successful in the program. It's going that extra step above and beyond of not just filling out what they give you, but having someone add a little bit extra, a little bit oomph, you know what I mean? So yeah, get on that early so that way they have a little bit of time to marinate on it and don't have to pop it out in a week or two. Okay. We're getting so close to getting into the program. I know it's a lot of steps, but that's every nursing school, right? The next thing that you're gonna need to do, and hopefully you've already done it, or you're scheduling it, is the TEAS test. So as you know, with a lot of nursing schools, they either require the TEAS test or they require the HISI test. People say that the TEAS is harder. I wouldn't know. I've only taken the TEAS test. I have not taken the HISI. So these are general subjects such as math, science, English language, and another subject. I forgot what it was. This is another step that I think helped me phenomenally with getting into the program because I did very well on it. You need to score proficient on the test. Me personally, I scored a 81.3, which is in the 90th percentile of the nation. So I did very well on it. I think they saw that I'm serious about the program and that I'm able to take the time out to study for the test. This is very similar to something like the SAT, ACT. So if you did well in those in high school, then brush a little dust off your books and I think you'll be okay. After you get all this stuff turned in, you'll have an intake interview with your enrollment counselor. So this is the person that you've been in communication with the whole time. They're telling you where to send your documents. They're pretty much your coach and your cheerleader throughout this whole enrollment process into the actual program. So you have your intake interview. When you have that intake interview with your enrollment counselor, make sure you bring a lot of energy to the table, show that you're really passionate, show that you are able to set aside the time to get the studies done, that you are a self-starter. And with that self-starter, that's why you want to get all this stuff in as fast as possible. Because once the enrollment counselor, she's your advocate, or he's your advocate, once they see that you're able to get these things done in a timely manner, they're going to vouch for you getting into the program. And I mean, that's it, guys. There's only a couple steps that you need to do to get accepted into their online nursing program. Again, remember that they love if you already have a degree, they love if you're working, and they love if you have a medical background. And they love self-start. Everything that you need to get done as fast as possible. I hope you found tremendous value in this video. I will continue to make videos about WGU, maybe tips on each term. If you have any questions, be sure to type them down in the comment box. If you love the video, then write Nurses Rock in the comment box. We'll talk to you next time. Peace.